Hey, just down below the video, if you click like, that'll make sure that YouTube shows this video to more people. Thanks. Two new functions come to Excel: translate and detect language. They are pretty cool. All right, so the first function is translate. Pass it any text, give it a source language code and a target language code. So for example here, I have some stuff in English, ask for equal translate that text. I'm not gonna have to put in English, it's the default. And then we're going to go to German. So let's see, there's a long list here of different codes. It's impressive. So there's German, DE, press enter. It's busy for just a tiny little bit, but we get the translation. Double click to copy that down. Yeah, boy, it's pretty quick. It looks like you can do about 200 calls at a time. Then you start getting connect errors. So that's pretty good. Let's try and go to several different languages. So here, is there a more efficient way to do this in Excel? So equal translate. And we'll translate that text. We'll press F4, comma, from English, so I don't have to put it in, and translate to that language. And so now, my problem is I don't know any of these languages, so you'll have to let me know down in the YouTube comments below. Oh wait, that one seems way too short, Arabic. But it turns out, because that's a right-to-left language, it turns out you have to make that wider to see the whole thing. It's kind of like it wants to spill out of this edge of the cell, and since there was already something there, it won't, you know, spill over the edge of the cell. Yeah, it looks pretty good to me. Again, let me know down in the YouTube comments if it works. And here's the other really amazing thing. It can detect the language. So there's a new function called detect language. We just pass it some text, and it will give us the code that it thinks it is, which means that if I wanted to translate these phrases back to English, I could simply just ask it for translate, and we'll leave the source language blank. They'll try and detect it, and we'll leave the other language blank, and it amazingly works. All right, that's great for people who speak English. You know, it's awesome for us that it defaults. Now, just a quick comparison here. Shout out to Smozgur from the Mr. Excel. He has a previous podcast where he talked about translating using Power Query through Google Translate, right? So this is lyrics to Simon and Garfunkel song. And he translated using the old method, translated using ChatGPT, and then translated using the translate function. Anytime that is in yellow, it's a match, right? So they're not exact matches. But there's several that match. And, missed opportunity here. Suo was pretty excited when he translated VLOOKUP to Turkish and got the exact correct thing. But that turns out that was just luck because it's giving us the wrong functions. Like this would have been a really good one for the Excel team. Just handle those, you know, the 500 Excel functions and make sure that those translate correctly. But overall, a really cool new function, you know, better than the old translate panel, which was just a real pain. You'll be able to translate, you know, up to 200 cells all at once. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.